Hello gamers and welcome to episode 5 of Let's Play Judgment. As I've loaded up the game, this popped up, stranger requires assistance. Well, we might. It's two minor demons. This survivor is tired, unfortunately. So, is he about to go to bed? He is. Awareness is low, which basically means I can go out and rescue him if he's still there when he wakes up. George is doing his stuff. The researchers are doing their stuff. What should be the next research goal? First aid. 120. Okay, who's tired now? George. But he won't fight anyway. Let's pause and go for them. They're all fit. So, I hope so at least. Let me quickly double check. Oh, she's really tired. And she's the best fighter. But it's only two minor demons, so... Well, there might be more. Is Tom a hippie? No, he's not. He's the opposite. So, let's take Tom. Annabelle, you have to stay at home. Brandon, you're not a hippie. Liz, you're not a hippie. David and Georgia. Now, Liz... You're also a bit tired though. You're fit. Tom, you're fit-ish. Well, I'll take her anyway. Now let's go. It's not that far, so... right click. There we go. Send rescue. How tired are you, Annabelle? I urgently need another bed. Okay, it was just about okay. So it was good to look at the minimap as well. Because it clearly indicates where the exclamation mark is your target. Shall I attack them? Can I actually do something like hold fire? I think I cannot. Okay, that's good. Really good. Now, maybe you, Tom. No, Brandon. Tom has a shield. That's pretty cool. So, Brandon. Come on, Brandon. I also take a quick screenshot. Maybe like that. No, even with an enemy on screen. Another demon, minor demon, that's no problem. And Annabella's going in for the kill. Stan, he looks kind of funny. Okay, let's speed things up. I'm not sure what happens if I retreat without being here, so I don't want to try. There we go. 35 XP for Annabelle. Return to base, yes please. Now let's check out Stan. Let's give you a weapon. Can you fight? Okay, you're an occultist. What can you do? You can kind of harvest, you can do research. That's good. So you can... Well, you can do rituals very well. Research also okay, so maybe we can prioritize your crafting and your, you know, fields stuff a little bit. David, you're a hippie anyway. Let's take a look at you. Melee da- okay, he's vegan. Melee damage minus 50%, accuracy minus 10%, medicine, he- okay, he's going to be like a doctor, I guess. Farm speed, farm yield, that's good. Maximum energy, occult research speed and rituals. So he should kind of do more farming than you because of the increased yield. Yeah, and he gets a bow quite obviously. And an armor. Food supply is looking good. But as I get more people, I need more stuff here. Will I get sheep wool here? Actually, maybe not. That really sucks because I do need wool. Tailoring unlocks scrap armor. Leather vest. Preserving expeditions. Cloth. Pasta, that's cool. Rainwater collector, nice. Vine armor, also nice. Alcohol, pretty cool. Might be that I can't get wool other than from raiding. I'd like to build another wheat farm and actually a sheep farm, but for that I do need more boards, but someone will start crafting in a bit. Okay, George is already on his way. No, he's not. He wants to construct first. Okay, that's okay. Awareness is now 22%. I do have the stove. I might make this like a defensive area. With spikes around. Or maybe spike that. I'm not sure yet what I'm going to do for defense. Or make like a, my stand here. Like an area like that. So that I put everyone inside this safeguarded area and can fight into every direction. Assistance needed. But they really need more beds, so I can't really help that person. No. And werewolves. No, thank you. Let's search for items. I do need wool, and wool can be found up there. Apparently. Huh. And down here maybe? Huh. 3 minor demons, 2 fire imps, 2 werewolves and 2 reapers. How many people can be in the task force? You can send a maximum of 5. But these 3 are not worth being sent. So I could only send these 4. What I can do is craft... Oh no, I need to go back to the camp. I can craft 1 more shield. weaken nearby enemies will weaken wielder as well. Well, might be an option. I'll craft one. I'd also like to bake some bread to increase food variety. Let's see how that goes. Now Liz is tired, unfortunately. She's one of the fighters as well. George is cooking. But he really likes crafting. That's good. But it also means... Okay, everyone is doing something here. Code research, Tom is doing the experiments. Level up for Tom, I guess. No, Brandon. He can do occult research. Okay, occult wielder. Holy crafting or dark crafting. Let's make him... Can he fight? Yes, he can. Let's make him the occult wielder. We will get some occult weapons eventually. No, Brandon. You get a shield. Let's actually craft more shields if possible. Okay, it's not possible. Because apparently I do need wood, I guess. Let's check the stockpile. I guess I do need wood. So T for task. And then let's chop some trees. All of them. Think big. And Annabelle, do you like chopping trees? No, you don't, but you do it anyway. Who else is chopping? Stan. Stan, do you like chopping trees? No. Liz does. Okay, let's do it. Come on, Liz. You need to level up. I've got quite a bit of water, so that's okay. Well... Need them to work here as well. Okay, lots of tired people. Annabelle, come on, go to bed. Let's check, where was this colony management here? So different food resources, that food types too. Natural heal rate goes up, so that's interesting. Really good. I can do some occult research. Light, okay, I can't do that. I could do that. Damage plus 7%, that's pretty cool. Maybe some rituals? No, I do need research materials. So I could actually slow down on the occult research a bit. You are really good. You're not that good. You can do some more farming now. Uh-oh, bad omens. Dark clouds cover the night sky. The soft glow of the moon breaches through what little seems... and holes it can find, illuminating with a weak, faint light, barely enough to see. A dark red comet streaks across the sky, coloring it in a dark crimson-red color. In what appears to be no less than witchcraft, the moon itself becomes red, its glow ominous. Demonic howls can be heard in the distance. These bad omens seem to give them unnatural strength. You search for an explanation for the red moon and its effect on the demons. Are interesting. Costs some research points that I can't spend. Great. At least not yet. which increases the enemy attack strength. Come on. Just 7 more points. 6. But I won't move this other guy. It's not worth it. He shall do more farming. I need more food. Lots of tired people, unfortunately. Did George actually craft the boards? Yes, he did. So let's do one more shield. And also do the research. Bad omens. Your survivors discover an ancient manuscript mentioning a blood moon and an old religious ritual used to protect against it. After performing the ritual, the moon returns to its normal pale self, and the demonic howls immediately begin to wane. Things are back to normal. That's pretty cool. The strange phenomenon must have had real mystical properties. In some dark corners around your colony, you find the strange demonite component that is commonly left behind after vanquishing more powerful demons. Wow. Nice. Can I craft a pain charm? Handle pain better. That's pretty cool. Do I have wool? Where would I get that much wool from? Well, apparently I do have lots of wool from the sheep, I guess. Even though there was no notification. I put another bed in here immediately. Okay, that's good. It will allow me to grow the colony. And we shall do that in the next episode of Let's Play Judgment. Thanks a lot for watching. Until then, bye for now.